Let's evaluate the limit as x goes to 0 of the absolute value of x over x. First, let me quickly remind you of an important fact. The absolute value of x can be written as a piecewise function. Negative x if x is less than or equal to 0, and x if x is greater than 0. And those pieces just represent the two sides of the v that you see on the absolute value function graph. So let's use that same logic to express the absolute value of x over x as a piecewise function. Okay, now when I write this piecewise function, I'm actually going to split it into three pieces. Okay, and the reason I'm doing this is because x equals 0 is sort of a special case with this function, and it's going to make it a little easier to think about if we think about it as three separate pieces. So what happens when x equals 0? Well, if I plug in x equals 0 to my function, I get 0 over 0. So the function is not defined here. Okay, so let's think about the other cases. First, let's think about x less than 0. So we know from what we wrote in green that if x is less than 0, the absolute value of x equals negative x. And then I also have an x in the denominator. So I have negative x over x. And I can reduce that to negative 1 since I'm not considering the case where x equals 0. Okay, so that's negative 1. Now let's look at the case where x is greater than 0. Well, once again, I know from what I wrote in green that the absolute value of x equals x in this case. And then, of course, I still have my x in the denominator. So once again, I can reduce this to 1 since I'm not considering the case where x equals 0, which we've just considered as a separate case, undefined. Okay, so I see my three pieces here. The function is negative 1, then it's undefined, and then it's positive 1. So let me quickly sketch what that would look like on a graph. Okay, so here is negative 1. Okay, so my function is negative 1 for values of x that are less than 0. And my function is positive 1 for values of x that are greater than 0. And notice that I've put open dots at x equals 0 to show that the function is undefined there. Okay, so now we have a better sense of the behavior of this function. So let's go ahead and work out the limit. Since this is a piecewise function, we need to look at the left-hand and the right-hand limits separately. So let's start with the left-hand limit. So I want to think about the limit as x goes to 0 from the left. Okay, so I'm looking over here at this representation of the function. And since I'm looking at 0 from the left, I need to pick the appropriate piece. Okay, so that 0 from the left is values less than 0. So I'm going to pick negative 1, the negative 1 piece. Now the limit as x goes to 0 of a constant is just that constant. So this equals negative 1. Okay, what about the limit as x goes to 0 from the right? Okay, well, x is going to 0 from the right, so now I'm considering x's that are greater than 0. So I'm going to pick this piece of the function. So now I've got the limit as x goes to 0 from the right, once again of a constant. So my answer is just that constant, which is 1. Okay, so what do we see here? The one-sided limits are not equal. So what does that tell us about the limit overall? It does not exist. Remember, the limit to a number does not exist if the one-sided limits are not equal. And we can see that from the graph as well. The one-sided limits are not equal, so the function overall isn't approaching a single value as x goes to 0.